Hi guys, welcome back. This is our part 2 of Spring Boot interview questions. We already completed our part 1. If you want to go through that video, I will attach a link of that video in description. You can get it from there. So without wasting time, let's start this video. So the first question of this video is, what is the minimum requirement if you want to work with a Spring Boot system? So if you want to work with a Spring Boot, what are the minimum requirements? So if like you have to use Java version 1.8 greater than 1.7, from 1.8 it is a minimum requirement, and Spring Framework 5.1.9, okay, and Maven, these are the like build tools, so you can use either Gradle or Maven. So in Maven it's 3.3 and Gradle it's 4.4, and with the servers and servlet versions, you have to, with Tomcat you have to use 9.0 and JT you have to 9.4, okay, and with the same with the servlet versions 3.1 and 4.0. So if you are telling these all minimum requirement, if you have knowledge, like you have tell this properly answer this question, right, with the minimum requirement, so might be possible he will ask you like, what is the latest version of Spring Boot, or what is the latest version of Java. So yeah, it's like might be possible he will ask or she will ask. So go through that once before attending your interview, what is the latest version of these softwares, okay? Yeah, because minimum requirement you are explaining, so might be possible you will know the latest version too. So okay, let's move to the second question on this. Okay, so if you are work with Spring application on your main class, where your main method is present, right, you know that we annotated that class with this annotation, like a Spring Boot and application. So what is the use of this application, annotation? So it's possible, like it's a like pretty important question when you are attending interview, because you know the basics before using anything, right? So why we are using this? So you know, like this annotation consists of three more annotations. So when you are using this single annotation, it will enable three more annotations, right? It is a combination of that three annotations. So but remember this introduced in 1.2.0. So if you are telling to your interviewer, like if you have given answer to your interviewer with this specific version, then it's a one positive point to you, like yeah, you have a knowledge of that, and with the specified versions also, it is a like good point towards you. So this is mean like using with this annotation, it enables addition of beans, okay, Spring Boot application to enable addition of beans using the class for definition. Okay, so this is a general definition, like it introduced in 1.2.0, and it is a convenient annotation which used in a Spring Boot application to enable additions of beans using class path definition. Okay, but the next question come in picture, how it enable to addition beans in class path, right? How it does? So the answer will come from those three annotations. So this is a question third. When you explain that, so if you just like you are using that application, so here we are mentioning Spring Boot, right? So this is an example of that Spring Boot where you are using. So if you can see that we are talking, right, Spring Boot application. So this annotations like made up of with this three combination of these configuration, enable auto configuration, and component scan, right? So as you have read this definition, it enable you the addition of beans, right? But how it does? So answer came from here, it does with the help of these three annotations. So when you are you said like, okay, your this Spring Boot application annotation is a combination of these three, okay, these three. So you might have knowledge, or you have knowledge of these three annotations, what the working of these three annotation. So if I give you the brief idea about all these three, this annotation is used with annotation beans wherever your class is like declaring your any beans or object, we can say. So you are using on top of that class, and on top of that method you are using a bean annotation. So this clear, first one. Second one, an enable auto configuration, it is enable your Spring Boot application to auto configure, okay. And component scan, suppose you are annotated one class with the component, okay, and you are telling your application whenever the container will up, like application context, if you have a knowledge of Spring Core, then you will have knowledge of containers, right? We have two type of containers in Go. So whenever your container will up, you want that particular class to be search as a component. Your container will search that class or load that class as a component. Okay, so this is a work of component scan. So if you just want to read about a whole working or how they works, so let me know. I will mention some resources for you. You can go through that and you will have a proper idea about that. Okay, so what is the fourth question of this video? That is, what is Spring application class? So if you have noticed when you using this your application or when you are working on project, right? Here we have this Spring application class, right? This one. So as you know, the one property of Java, like if we have our static method in our Java, you can call it by the class name, right? So this is a run is a static method here, and this is Spring application is a our class. Okay, so move to our question. Yeah, what is this Spring application class and what is working of this, like why we are using or someone. So if you can read it here, this Spring Boot application class is used to bootstrap and launch your Spring application from Java main method, because in that we have main method. Okay, in this class automatically create application context, as I mentioned in previous question, application context is our container. Okay, application context, and from class path scan configuration classes. Yeah, any configuration classes is there, like if you annotate it with some class as a configuration class where your bean will be declared inside that class, right? Or bean will be initialized. So launch application and launch our application. So this is a working of this Spring application class. So it is a pretty basic but most important question. Okay, if someone asks you what is a Spring application and you are not in position to tell this answer, I don't think so, like interview will go further. Okay, so let's move to the next question. Yeah, what are the step of deploying your Spring Boot web application as jar or var? Okay, if you can how can you do that, right? So first, there in plugin in your pom.xml file, you have to add this artifact and group ID in this plugin, and inside that package you can add that jar or var. Okay, what whatever that you want to use. Here if we go to the question here, inside it we have this add property plugin. Inside that you are using this group ID and artifact ID, and we have one thing in your form, we call it as package. Okay, inside that package you can mention like whatever you want to use, either or either you want to use jar. Okay, and after mentioning all these both things, you can get the jar file and you can do whatever you want to do with that. Okay, yeah. Okay, like sixth question is, can you disable a particular auto configuration in Spring Boot? Yeah, as I told you, right, like there is a configuration, if you mention that configuration annotation on annotated one class at configuration, right? So how can you disable that, like how can you tell your application like to do not consider that? So we have a two ways. Either you can use this attribute exclude, okay, inside your at the rate enable auto configuration, and you can say like if you have a class data source auto configuration dot class. Okay, so just mention this class inside the curly braces, it will be excluded. And if you don't want to use this first one, then go for a second one, Spring Boot application annotation exclude and data source auto configuration dot class. So this is a two ways we can exclude one particular class. Okay, and if you know that like Spring Boot, whenever the application will up, it will start searching all the component from your base package. Okay, so either if you want to exclude particular thing, just do some modification in your packages, or either it, this is a, these two ways is the best of excluding anything. Okay, so what is the seventh question? That is, if someone yeah, might possible they will ask in like Spring MVC flow. Yeah, because you are working with the Spring Boot, right? You should know the Spring MVC flow. So if I want to talk about the Spring MVC flow, this is your web browser, right? This is your working as a client. And yeah, I just got this image from Google. Okay, So like you are just hitting on endpoints, so some API or okay. So there is your dynamic, display sort of dispatcher chocolate. Okay. So first point is the request come here. Okay. And second point, it will go to the handle mapping. It will tell, okay, for this particular endpoint, if we have a controller or not. It will give you the proper name and location of your controller, and again it come to the dispatcher. Dispatcher is nothing doing anything here. It is just asking something to the component, and it will give the response. Okay, yeah. But it is a main component here. Okay, it is doing every activity here. Now it has a control name and its location. It will go to the controller right here. As you see, we are hitting the location right, like home controller with this. These are the endpoint slash home. Okay, so if you can see here, this is slash home here. Okay, it will come here at a controller, like home controller Java class. It is, we are annotated at REST controller, and it at fifth point, like it will goes to this model, and it will what it does, it will give the model map view. Okay, and it will come here, and after getting that model map view, it will come to the dispatcher, and dispatcher from it will come the view resolver. Why? It will give the view, like physical name of that view. When if you work with a like .jsp, or if you haven't worked with JSP file and name, you can see that in web folder we are mentioning .jsp web inf, right? So if you can relate to my words, what I'm saying, if you like not relate, just go through my Spring boot projects. So where in there I have using the same thing with this same model. Okay. So after getting the view and all, it will come to again to here and go to the view component and take that view, like either JSP or tiles or whatever it is, like home.jsp, right? The same example I am just used in my project. So you can go through that one, so you have a clear idea. Okay, and again when hit enter go, it get to the client. So pretty simple architecture of this MVC. Okay, so now move to the our next question. It is okay. So what is our next question is, what is the name of the configuration file which you use in the Spring Boot? Yeah, this is a pretty basic question, but you have to remember this. Okay, yeah, we easily can't forget this, but it's possible sometime we forgot. Okay, so what is a like configuration file where we do all the configurations? It's like application.property properties. Okay, so this is easy. So let's come to the ninth question. Explain difference between JPA. Yeah, when you are using when you are working with the some your project, you are working on one project, right? You might be possible you are using your databases, right? Because API, every API need to be interact with the, not every API, okay, but yeah, most of the time you have to work with the APIs and using a database. Okay, so you have on your database layer, in that layer you what you are using, like it's depend on your project requirement, Spring data or whatever. So you are using, so yeah, of course you have an idea of JPA and Hibernate. So the question will come, and most of the people don't know this. When I have started my project, seriously I don't know the difference between it. Okay, so JPA specification, what is JPA and Hibernate? So JPA is a specification, like what does it mean of a specification? Some set of rules or something the people, JPA people provide. Okay, if someone want to implement this, you can use this. Okay, like that. So JPA is a specification, okay, and whereas Hibernate is one of the implementation of JPA. Okay, and as same with like what is the one question will came, Spring data, what is a Spring data? Okay, so you can search on that also. Yeah, so our last question for this video, I think we have completed like pretty much everything with the question which I have, like they asked to me in interviews. Okay, so what is our last question is, how do you configure error logging and debugging in a Spring Boot application? So we can do this by go to the application.property file. You can just mention the these property, logging level, org.framework bank, debug, and like Hibernate error. So you can just set any level. Okay, if you have any idea of logging framework, like logging log4j or someone, so or some other framework, you can relate to my words what I'm saying here. Okay, yeah, so this is like pretty we have covered many questions in these two videos. Okay, so yeah, much enough for this video. I will see you in next video. Till then, bye bye, see you.